Hello everyone, this is Sudipto from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. In today's video, I'm going to show you about a new feature which is coming up with summer 23 release. Now you can call a HTTP post method from your Salesforce Flow. This feature is currently in a beta release, but let me create this feature in one of the Salesforce summer 23 org and show you how you can configure this and take full advantage of this new feature. So let's go and dive into our Salesforce summer 23 release org. This is the API that I'm going to use for this demo. It's called RESTful API dev, and I have configured this in my postman. So basically it's a post call, and if I pass this message, this is the response that I'm getting. So I'm going to call this method. I'm going to call this post method from the Salesforce Flow and see how we can get this response back. To do that, first thing I need to do, I need to create external credential. So I'll search for name credential, go to the external credential and click on new, and I'm going to give a name as test post call. In the authentication protocol, I choose custom and click on save. Now here, from the summer 23 release, you will get a new option called principal. Previously you used to add the permission set directly from this page, but after summer 23 release, you need to create principal and add that to your permission set. So I have a dedicated video for that where I've explained how you can do that. You should go and check this out. I'll put the link on the top right corner as well as the description of this video. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create some principal here. I'm going to give a name as one. In this parameter, I'm going to choose as my name and put some value and click on save. It's going to create the principal. With that, what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a permission set. Let me create a permission set. Test post call permission set. Save that, assign this permission set to myself. And once the assignment is done, I'll go to the permission set section again. And here is a section called external credential principal section. And I'm going to click on edit and add the new one, which is test post call. This is a principal I've created from the name credential section. I'll add that principal to this permission set. And it's done. I'll go back to the name credential again. So I've created the external credential. Now I'm going to create the next name credential. I click on new. I give test post call named credential. In the URL, I'll pass this URL. In the external credential section, I'll select the one that I've created, which is test post call. I'm not generating any header and all this thing, and click on save. So I've created external credential, I've created a name credential, I've created a permission set and added the principal to the permission set. So my basic setup is done. Now I'm going to create the flow. It will be a new flow. In the new flow, it's taking a bit of time. Okay, so it will be a screen flow. Click on that. Here I'm going to click on this action, and I'm going to click on this HTTP callout action. Here I'm going to give a name as post call. In the name credential, I'm going to choose the credential which I've created, which is test post call name credential, and click on next. Let's give a name post call action. Here you'll find this option called post. Previously it was only get that you can do from the flow, but right after summer 23 release, you can do the post call, though this function is in a beta state. So I'll select post. Here in the URL path, I am going to pass this option, which is slash objects. I don't have any parameter. Here, I have to provide some sample request and sample response. So I click on new. In the sample request, I'm going to paste this option. And the moment I click on review, it's going to parse the value and choose the proper type of the request. Click on done. I have to do the same thing for the response. So I select this one and here provide sample response. I click on new and this, and then click on review. It's going to parse the response and put proper data type. Click on done and click on save. It will bring me back to this page. I'll give a name as external post call. Good. In the body section, I need to create a resource, which is basically my input. The thing that you need to remember, the data type should be Apex defined. And here you need to search for the class, which is external service. And then it will be the post call. Yeah, it will be the external services post call in body. So I'll select this option and done, and then click on done. So my flow is ready. Actually, it's not ready, but I'll show you. Post call from flow. So I've configured the flow and added the post call. The only thing I need to do here, this is the variable, right? So I need to assign values to the variable. So here I'm going to create one assign statement, assignment block, and assign values. Here I'll select this one, which is input body, and first is name. The name should be this value. So I'm going to pass that here. I'm going to add everything one by one, which is data, and then CPUX, which is this one. Next is hard, and the value should be 1 TB. Then another one is input data, and then price. I can choose 1849.99. You can choose any value. Let's say for example, I choose 999.99. You don't need to follow all the time the same value which you have given as a sample request. And then the year, I can choose this year, and then done. So my flow is ready. So let's quickly review what I've done. I've created this one, which is basically the external call, but this is a post call. And here is the Apex defined input variable. And before that, I have added all the values to this Apex defines variable. So now go and activate that and click on debug. The moment I do that, you will see from the debug detail that this is my assignment block. This is my actual call. The actual call happened, and this is the response that I've received. In the actual call, I set the price as 999 and also the year as 2023. And this is the response that I have received. So this is the way how you can configure your flow to call a post method. I have a dedicated video where I've shown you how you can configure your flow to call the HTTP GET method. But in this release, Salesforce is bringing how you can call your HTTP POST method from flow. Again, this feature is in a beta release, but it's a very powerful feature. Because now from your flow, you can call HTTP GET and HTTP both the methods. I hope this video is helpful. Please hit the like icon and share, and please subscribe to my channel to get update about all my upcoming videos. Till then, thank you. Bye bye.